We got 3-on-3 hockey here for 5 minutes. And it's not too often you see these games go to a shootout. Mainly, 3-on-3 hockey ends up being a back-and-forth type thing. And basically looking for one mistake, one guy to slip, to fall, to do much of anything. And create an odd man opportunity going back the other way. And then it just becomes one after the other. And we'll see how it happens tonight. Elitis, he's going to go, and Price is going to join the rush with him. Of course, Price can't play forward. Oh, he went high and hard, and that's going to come all the way around, and back they come. And this is what we talked about. We've already got the back and forth going. The shot wide of the net. Wilson gets calmly pushed the puck against the boards. He took a hard hit there, and it's going to send all the way back, so things going to calm down. Team's going to go for a change real quick. Lusick staying out there, but Kozlovsky and Offrey, so Riverhawks going to two forwards and one D, and of course, like I said, Price can play both forward and D, so he's a useful guy in this situation. You can trust him at every end of the ice. Now Lusick's going to give Whitehead a little bit too much space. Whitehead decided to stop up. Now a lot of room for Whitehead, walks right in. Oh, big stop there as McLaughlin just got a piece. Riverhawks are going to have to sew up that zone. Offrey hauled down his man, and he's going to get called for it. And Liscombe had a hold of his stick. It was clear as day right in front of us. And it's going to be 4-on-3. And that's disappointing if you're a Riverhawks fan. And I'm not going to say much more than that. But give the official the benefit of the doubt there and say that even though Liscombe looked like he had a hold of Offrey's stick, maybe he didn't. And Offrey goes off for holding, which is an interesting call since he had two hands on the stick. But anyhow, 3:55 left in the overtime period, and Riverhawks have to kill off the next 2 minutes here. 4-on-3. This is always a difficult circumstance to kill off here for any team. Trying to see what the stoppage is for here. We've got the right penalty up on the board as far as we can tell. Oh, it's a 1 minute, so yeah. And so I apologize, that's my... No, there's more confusion, so hold on. Before I apologize, I'll try to make it out. It seems to be confusion over what exactly the penalty is right now. It's a minor penalty. Now, whether that's worth 1 minute in the box in overtime or 2 minutes is the key. 1 minute's on the board. Head coach Todd Gordon for the IceFlyers doesn't seem too pleased with that. The official coming back to the penalty box. There's some pretty intense discussions going on down there, and trying to read lips as best I can, but it's a little difficult from this vantage point. Music man here at James Brown Arena is going to have to switch over to something soon. Looks like it's going to, now it's back to 2 minutes, so it's a 2 minute man advantage. So as initially ruled, it will be a 2 minute power play. Puck goes back to the point. Hins over to Wilson. Such a dangerous power play the Flyers have here. Back across, back up to Hins, and he didn't get all of that one. No broken stick, he just got too much of the ice, I believe. Hins now at the top. Down low, Wilson, one-timer, and a good stop there. And the puck is cleared. 1:34 left in the power play. Hins, the captain, moves across the blue line. Gets a hack there from Alitas. Back up top to Ehrman. Over to Hins. Hins. Back to Ehrman. He's got the big hammer, and he's going to one-time it. That was blocked in front, I believe, off the rear end of Whitehead. Whitehead takes a little hack there from McLaughlin. Here's Wilson. Cross to Ehrman. Ehrman's creeping in close. Wilson tried to handle that off the skate. 1:03 left in the power play. Whitehead through the slot. Back up for Ehrman. Across, and that was one of the, it looks like Alitas who hit the ice there. Now across to Ehrman and stopped by McLaughlin. Puck goes harmlessly into the corner. Wilson back up to Ehrman. It's too many shots. Riverhawks have to get a clear shot. Big save. Rebound. He scores, and that's going to do it. And that is ball game, folks. Overtime victory for the Ice Flyers.